Okay.
Oh, do you want to hear the boring story? Here's no, boring story. No one wants to hear a boring story.
Yeah, basically, anyway, it all froze. We changed computers, but we went live.
Hope this works.
It's still not that interesting, but just cut it.
Thank God StreamYard is sending us. They're the platform folks, and they're very nicely, generously sending us a desktop.
Yeah.
That will be solely used for the show, nothing else.
Yeah.
And hopefully that will alleviate a lot of these problems.
Wow, that was a nightmare. Yeah, last night, like, Cheetah just froze. Anyway, I can't.
Yeah.
Point is, this is Stars in the House. Hashtag never again. No, it's Stars in the House. 2 o'clock and 8 o'clock shows we do every day, 2 p.m. Eastern. And then it says at starsinthehouse.com. And we do it to bring people to get money for the Actors Fund.
The technology works.
Yeah, we should just do an artist rendering of the show instead of actually.
Well, the last 3 minutes actually would have been, I guess, enjoyable.
It's just a lot it's breaking up our marriage, but we are helping the Actors Fund.
Stop saying that. It's not true.
Maybe for one of us.
Okay. You have something to tell me.
You'll
okay,
hear from my
it.
Lawyer. My lawyer is not working. God, no, it has to be. No, it's like 1,000%.
Yeah. Wait, instead of you're never good at math. So let's just leave it there. It's a lot more people
than they've ever had
needing
before.
Help. Yes.
So if you can go, what you do is you donate at Stars in the House, but then can you please email? Do you see right next to it? Yep. StarsInTheHouse2020@gmail.
Oh, good luck.
Oh, now we're frozen.
Oh, jeez.
Well, we look frozen. Maybe we're not. So I'm just going to keep talking like it's.
I don't know.
So anyway, we're going to donate. You donate at starsinthehouse.com and you email starsinthehouse2020@gmail.com.
Is it working? I think
yes,
we
it is.
Text people. Okay.
So if it's crazy frozen, just text me. David, just text me if it's crazy frozen. Or Nancy, just text me if it's crazy frozen.
Or Beth Level or any of those.
Anybody people. Text me if it's crazy frozen.
There you go. It's crazy
no,
frozen.
No, no one's. Yeah, I knew it. We can hear everything you're saying. Exactly what I said. I know
we'll
computers.
We'll do the best we can.
I took a computer class in 1983. I know computers.
Yes. What was that kind of computer called?
Commodore?
No.
Exactly.
Commodore.
Wait, Commodores? Thanks for the times that you gave.
Simpler times.
Anybody at the Commodores? Anybody.
Yes.
Okay, guys, that's all the time we have for the show. What?
I'm nervous to read. There's these amazing emails that came in.
We got to read them while they're here because they're about to prom, aren't they?
They are. So
let's wait till people are here.
So we'll wait. Okay.
So we're going to start with the young couple from the prom. I'm going to bring up Isabel. So hold on. Here's lovely Isabel. Will anything work on my computer? Okay, it's frozen again. Hold on. I know that you can hear me babbling. By the way, my face frozen. It's not attractive. Okay. That's just the first thing I have to say. So, well, you know what?
I don't know.
Caitlin is nearby. Let's check Caitlin.
Hi!
Oh, my God.
I'm here.
Hi,
you
Caitlin.
You are freezing, but we can hear everything.
Oh, so you can hear all the cursing? Okay.
All of it.
Here's your girlfriend, Isabel.
Oh,
wow.
I don't know why it's acting like this. It's never done this before.
Yeah.
It's technology.
But it's like, this is show number, like, 81. I'm going to try Isabel again.
Oh, hi!
Babe! Oh.
Hi, babe!
Hi, babe!
I think you're very attractive frozen, Seth.
No, you're not seeing what I see. Let me just say, I don't want to talk about it ever again. Okay, so the people that are like, what is the prom? Isabel, can you please describe the plot of the prom?
Sure, absolutely. So the prom, it happens, we open on the opening night of Eleanor, the Eleanor Roosevelt musical. And these four Broadway actors are down on their luck and they're deciding they need to revive their careers. So Angie goes on Twitter and finds a story about a lesbian in Indiana who wants to take her girlfriend to the high school prom, but as a result, the PTA decided to cancel it. So they decide to march down to Indiana, right all the wrongs, and obviously chaos ensues and everything falls apart. And so that is the story. Caitlin is our protagonist. She's Emma Nolan, the our lesbian, leading lesbian, if you will. And I'm the supporting lesbian, her girlfriend, who is
lesbian.
In the closet. Yes, I'm the supporting lesbian.
That is I would say that is a Tony Award category, supporting lesbian, and yeah, I applaud you for it. So Caitlin and Isabel, when did you guys get involved with the prom? Were you one of those like, you know, in the very first workshop when I was 12, or were you like the last minute I joined? Which one?
Combo.
It's different.
The very first workshop when I was 12, and Izzy was later on in the story.
The last minute at 5 minute call. Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
So, Caitlin, you were there from the very beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Like when it was just like a reading, Caitlin?
Yeah, I did the first 29-hour reading back in 2014.
Wow.
Oh my God. Yeah. Was that right when you're doing Bridges in Madison County?
It was right after that. Yeah, we had closed Bridges back in like, May. And then prom was like December of that year.
And Isabel, when you auditioned, did they do like a chemistry test between you and Caitlin?
They didn't. So I auditioned, I joined the show in Atlanta for our out-of-town tryout in 2016. And I was in the ensemble at that point. Mm-hmm. And then through just shifting in terms of the way the character was rewritten, Casey Nicol, our director, got to know me a little bit better when I did the Aladdin tour with him. That he asked me to do Alyssa Green, and we kind of just like were thrown into the lab in January together. And it was kind of like, hope this works. And luckily,
and it did.
It did. We had some good chemistry. I think it was the first day of rehearsal in the lab. Caitlin looked at me and she said, I didn't think it was possible, but they found somebody weirder than I am to be my girlfriend. And that was the start of a love story.
And here we are today.
Yeah. So many people I know had so many strong reactions to the prom. What kind of experience did you have with either stage doors or emails? Because I'm so fascinated with, you know, with Broadway shows that can really touch people. Like, give me some examples of who came up to you or who wrote to you.
Everyone. That was what was so cool about the show, is that it had something for everyone. And the people who would reach out to us were truly all walks of life. It was young kids. It was adults. It was people who had been out for years. It was people who just came out today. It was everyone. Yeah. And they just, the amount of love and support and understanding we got, and the people saying like, we feel seen and represented in ways that we never have on Broadway before. Thank you for telling this story. It was incredible. And it's still happening to this day. I still get messages on Instagram. I still get people reaching out saying, you changed my life. Thank you. And it just like, I call prom the gift that keeps giving, and it truly just is like this wonderful part of our hearts and other people's hearts now that just keeps coming and keeps building love, and it's the most amazing thing.
Yeah. Wow, James, you want to read the letter?
Yeah,
from that? Let's see. We got one.
We got a few here. I think this one maybe at from Emma. And we've read this actually before, but because you guys are specifically mentioned, I think it's worth mentioning again. I'm a closeted LGBTQ teen, and this period has been difficult in terms of returning to my home environment from university. For myself and many others in similar situations, returning to homes that are not affirming of our queer identities is challenging, but your daily pieces bring so much light into our days. Along this line, I wanted to pass along a request to have the original Broadway cast from The Prom on your show.
Noted.
I know that for many, this show and its cast album is an important touch point during this challenging time. So to prove your point, Caitlin, right there.
So Emma, there you go. Yeah. By the way, just Brooks, if you're listening, I got your check about my frozen face, and we'll be discussing it. I got your check.
Gosh.
Wow. A lot of chutzpah. So the two of you, so you guys are still, that's what's so great about having a cast album and having clips online. And it's so nice that, you know, look, I love falsettos, but let's be honest, when they did the Tony Awards, it was like, this show is about baseball. Like, it was so like, we refused to acknowledge like that the show was really about, you know, this gay couple. And there was so much gayness in it, and they really toned it down. And the poster was like, it's about family. So I just love that the producers were like, on the Macy Day, you guys really got to do your thing. You guys got to smooch to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, didn't
we
you?
We did.
It was the first LGBTQ kiss on the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade in history, which was amazing.
And what was the feedback on that? Because that's really different, because that obviously more people see that than probably any Broadway show.
And they're being forced to see it. They're not coming to see it. Right. It's just in front of them. Yes. Yeah. What was the feedback on that?
Varied. Mainly it was overwhelming love and support, and but then at the same time there was some organization that was like, our children's innocence has been ripped from them, but we were a part of the conversation, like we were part of the dinner table, you know, that night, which is amazing that people were talking about this love and this kiss that is so innocent and pure and beautiful that was just represent, you know, represented. I mean, like, we got so many letters from that day where people saying, oh my gosh, I just saw myself you validated my family. Like, this is what my family looks like. Thank you.
Yeah. It became about families. Yeah. And it became that, like, this is what love can look like. And it doesn't matter. What matters is that we're in love and we're together. And so to be able to share that message with America was overwhelming.
Yeah.
And Isabel, actually, probably a lot of the families that were objecting were like your family in the prom, because your mother's objecting having a lesbian at the prom. And it turns out your daughter's a lesbian. So it's interesting. I'm sure there were a lot of parents that were like, my child's innocent. And the child was like, I'm actually gay. So hush.
Yes. Yes. I mean, yeah. And there were so many people that said they came out at Thanksgiving dinner because of our show. Yeah. The stories that we heard from this day, and the shifts in their families and the conversations that started. Like, I'm just so glad that we opened the door to those conversations. I think that is the best thing that came out of our show and that kiss on the parade.
Yeah.
Aww. Yeah. Wow. Right. Yeah, because lesbians aren't that represented on Broadway in the first place. And certainly, certainly not teens. Have there been any other teen lesbians on Broadway?
Medium Allison in Fun Home is a teenager. Right. But what was so cool about our show is that, like, it was young teen lesbians represented in a positive light. You know, that our story ended with a happy ending, and it ended with us together and in love and sharing that. You know, it wasn't only about the negative aspects of being gay. You know, we were like, no, this can be awesome and great, and we'll have a dance party at the end.
Right. It wasn't like the bell jar. Anybody else? Reference? So wait, you know, the annoying thing about this platform, besides being completely frozen.
Completely annoying today.
Is that we can't have a lot of people on the platform at the same time. So Isabel, I want you to do your song, which I know you magically found a track for.
So I did. I magically found a track for it.
And then we'll bring on.
Because it's truly, talk about, you know, it can be uplifting. This song may not be that uplifting, but it's Alyssa Green before she decides to find her courage and be there for her girlfriend.
She grows.
She's struggling with her anxiety. She grows. Yeah, she's a lovely arc.
And I just want to remind people, you donate at starsinthehouse.com, and then you get the receipt, and you email that receipt to starsinthehouse2020@gmail.com. And then we'll have one of these lesbians or older actors who are trying to revive their careers read the donation.
I love that.
Art imitates life. Amazing. All right. So maybe if I leave the screen, this is going to be dangerous. If we don't come back, girls, just take over the show.
We got you.
Sounds like a plan. We got this. All right. All right, babe.
Oh, I get to
Oh my God. Do you want to do the lines in between?
I don't know
I don't either. Just don't laugh at me. I mean, you can laugh at me. That's okay. Okay. I'll be serious now. Okay. Here we go.
You got this, babe.
Shift the gears.
Okay.
The hair has to be perfect. The A's have to be straight. You have to join the debate club on that. There's no debate. You'll have Bible camp each summer to keep you pure and clean. Endless rules apply when you're Alyssa Green. Trophies have to be first place. Ribbons have to be blue. There's always some competition or hoops for jumping through. Your mom's made sacrifices, so win homecoming queen. Cause it's do or die when you're Alyssa Green. And you wish there was a world where you were simply free to live. And when people criticized you, you had no more shits to give. And in this other lifetime, when you tell yourself, be brave, you won't cave. That's the one thing I truly crave. But your feelings have to be phony. Your weight has to be tracked. If you don't like shaking pom-poms, you'd better learn to act. Just have everything perfected by the time you reach 18. Don't ask how or why when you're Alyssa Green. Improve all of your strong points and hide things that you lack. Cause mom's convinced if you're perfect, your father might come back. You're not yourself. You're not what she wants. You're someone in between. Your whole life's a lie when you're Alyssa Green. Babe, I want to come out to you, but I'm so scared.
Something about, I'm going to tell my own story. Will you do it with me?
I can't. Do yourself. She wants your someone in between. Walk off. Bump, bump,
bump, bump, bump. Babe, I'm hearing you sing that.
Oh, man. Thanks. It's fun. I haven't. It was like, oh, what is this story again? Who is she?
Oh my God, the comments are amazing. Lizzie says she's not crying, but someone is cutting onions.
Thanks, Lizzie. I'm glad it had an effect.
So, Isabel, we got to extend you, but hang around because we may be able to bring you back.
That's all good. No worries.
Okay.
Thanks like for having me.
All right, you still got it. All right, see you soon. Let me see if I can actually get rid of you. You may actually be stuck. There we go.
Show.
Okay, so at this point, we added the Ethernet. It's still not sucking. Okay, so at this point.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, hold on.
We can still hear you.
Okay, good.
So, excellent.
So first we're gonna bring
that
in
part's good.
Bring in my glamazon, Angie Schwer. She's 7'8" and she's still got it.
Still one. Got it.
Woo!
Oh, the shirt.
Yay.
Well, you know. I was trying.
Okay. And then we are bringing on a certain Tony Award winner who has, I think, my favorite background today because of the yellow chair. Let me see the shorts. Please welcome the lovely Elizabeth Lavelle. Hi, Beth.
Hi, darling. I have some faces I'd like to show you because I've memorized them as you froze.
Oh, no.
I don't know if I'm interested.
Oh, yeah, you'll be interested. Maybe later. Continue. Okay.
Then I'd like to bring up, let me see if this actually works. Wow. This is so weird. It's never done this.
I think I may be going upstairs to look at this on our TV.
Oh, okay. I think Chris Sieber's Wi-Fi conked out, actually, because he was on and he left.
It's been going on and off.
So Chris Sieber, peace out, because he actually lives near us. I think maybe it's just bad Wi-Fi up here.
Maybe we're gonna go investigate here.
Maybe it's the island.
He said he'd be right back, Chris Sieber.
We all say that.
The best face was when Izzy said people came out at Thanksgiving, and both of you went and froze.
That wasn't a face thing. That was in shock for 10 minutes. And then finally, the man who just loves to text me with a lot of sassy comments, Brooks Ashmanskis. Will he appear?
Woo-hoo! Hi,
Brooksy. How are you?
So,
looking good, Seth.
Brooks claims that my frozen face resembles a certain female producer by the name of Fran Weisler.
There was only one where it was going to work. Hi, Seth. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Namaste. Brooks, you just moved. I love the oars in the background.
I know. They're going up soon. We moved like 2 days ago.
Wow.
But there's the fireplace.
It's
beautiful.
It's so beautiful.
It's so great.
We'll be right there.
So lucky to be here.
All right, so all you clowns, let's talk about how you got involved. Brooksy, how did you get involved with this?
It was the easiest job in a way to get for especially us old people in that I remember I went to some benefit at the Delacorte Theater, which is in Central Park, and Casey Nicholaw was there. This was years ago. This was like 9 years ago. I don't know, something like that, 10. And we were talking about something else completely. And he said, oh, I have this show that you have to do. And then cut to, we're sitting here right now.
That was your audition going to another show?
Yeah, no, I had known Casey for a long time, but I'd never, at that point, never worked with him. I hadn't even done Something Rotten yet. So this was just, he knew what he was looking for. Idiot that he is.
All right. It worked, though. And yeah. Beth, you'd already started as a chaperone on the Tony with Casey. You knew him from Crazy for You. So was this another just phone call to you?
ish. I was doing Elf, and it was so much fun. I asked Matt Sklar and Chad Baglin. I said, "Let's do something else." And they paused. It was like, Cut to Casey called and said, "Can you just come and sit around a table and read this thing?" Right. And 9 years later, and you know that opportunity hardly ever happened. That Brooks, Angie, Chris, and I were sitting around a table. No. For roles that were literally written for us. I mean, they were going, let's get a character like Angie Schwarr. And they went, well, why don't you just get Angie Schwarr? And the rest is history.
And literally name her Angie, not since Bonnie Franklin. I mean, seriously, Bonnie was Bonnie in Applause.
Right.
I guess I was on the set of Smash with Casey directing, and we were going to craft services to get a Diet Bev, and he said, we're writing this show, and we call the character your name. We call her Angie Schwarr with his cute little face. And then, you know, when it wasn't happening for so long, I kept saying, can we get this show done so you're not looking for a young Angie Schwarr?
Well, hold on. I think Chris may be back. Now, the problem is Chris didn't know we were doing a show, so he's just in like a bad tank top. But, sorry, Chris. Next time you gotta come to work.
And oh, like just gorgeous.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
You look gorgeous, Christopher.
I had to come over to the other house because for some reason the internet at the other house wasn't strong enough. So I had a whole
The other house.
Yeah, the other house, yeah.
On the island.
Yeah, very difficult.
On my private island, yes.
In a tux.
In a tuxedo.
All right, so Chris.
Yes, hi.
I'm going to try to show a picture of you. My husband says that I'm frozen and I should just get off the show and have you guys host, but I'm enjoying it too much. So he can add.
I'm alive every now and then, which is nice.
You do.
So Chris, let's first discuss this. If we can. Hold on, is it working?
That's junior and senior year of high school. That's Cricket Osterbauer. And the picture on the left, I had gone to prom before with someone who was, no one asked her because she was one of the most popular girls in school. No one asked her. So she was a bit disappointed. And so she asked me, and I happened to be friends with her brother. And so she said, hey, you want to go to prom? And I'd never been to prom. I think I was in ninth grade at the time, maybe 10th grade. I don't know. And I realized that it was just awful because the parents were allowed to come and take pictures. And back in the 80s, there were like these big video cameras with the suitcase, you know, VCR and everything. And they had a roped off section so the parents could stay there all day and all night and take pictures and video of their kids. And I was like, this is lame. This should be our night. So then the following day, the first time Cricket and I said, find the most hideous dress you could find. And I want the most hideous tux that I could find. And then it doesn't show it there because we were respectful for the photo. We wore roller skates the entire time. Phone.
That's my agent. Don't even get me started. Okay, so hold on. Oh, wait. So, Christopher, you actually, it's not like you went to the prom and you were sort of popular. Brooks, what was your experience in high school?
Well, I went to both my proms as well with friends. But, I mean, I wouldn't say I was popular. I was just, you know, thinner. You know, like a thinner version of this. Much thinner. So much thinner than this. But I was, you know, I wasn't like a nerd or anything, or not that bad, but I went to both my proms with friends and had actually really great experience. I thought it was fantastic. So the thought, you know, when we were working on this show, like the thought of people not being able to go for the stupidest of reasons, I was like, I couldn't believe that. I still can't believe it. I think it's so gross. And, you know, I'm so glad I didn't have to go through that.
Yeah.
Betty, you're from the South. Did you go to prom or cotillion, as they called it?
Yes, I went to cotillion. But cotillion and prom are not the same thing. Cotillion was when, in junior high school, we go to classes to learn how to ballroom dance.
Oh.
Wow.
Yes, and we wore little gloves. So I, to this day, can foxtrot and samba. And maybe
I want to see a samba from Beth Level.
I cannot wait to get out of this apartment. Yes, I went to the prom, but I went with a pal because we really, really, really liked to dance. And, you know, this was the disco era and we had a really good time.
Did anybody have a makeout session at the prom? You guys were all with your friends. Angie, surely you went to third base or something.
I probably did some making out, you know, with my braces.
I went to
an all-girls Catholic high school. So I went to my two proms, and then the all-boys Catholic high school was across the street. And so I went to that prom too. I was just prom. I feel bad for the people now, you know, that the kids that are graduating and they can't do any of their things.
Yeah.
So I was lucky, but I'm sure there was making out. Not much more. I was kind of a prude.
Well, I didn't make out with my date.
Who did you make out with?
Well, I'm not telling.
Brooke, it's been 50 years. You can tell.
No, he's married an accountant in Georgia now.
Yeah, I have to be. I mean, I have to be very, very careful with what I say here in the public area. You know, but yeah, I a lot of people.
Brooks, I just texted you a list. Our first list of donations. We're gonna do donations. Read them.
Okay, hang on. Let me pull it up. Do I read this whole thing? Good God.
Yes.
Okay. Hi. Meg from Illinois, $10. Tiffany from Pennsylvania, $24. $25. Can't read. Can't see. Thank you so much for all you do with Stars in the House. It brings much needed joy and light into my life. Today, I donated to the Actors Fund in honor of Beth Level, who also brings light and joy into my life. Kira from Connecticut, $10. I've been saving all week to donate to the Actress Fund on behalf of Stars in the House. Shannon from New Jersey, $154.
Thank you.
The Palm is an amazing show and means so much. Jennifer from Missouri, $20. Love the prom. Margaret from New Jersey, $103. Jersey's rich today. So happy to donate to this organization and join my favorite cast for this live event. Arthur from Florida, $103.
Thanks, Arthur.
Michael and James from California, $206. My husband, James, and I love the prom. Traveling from San Francisco to see it 5 times, including the final performance. Bittersweet, but the final performance was amazing. Thanks for the memories that will last a lifetime. Thank you all.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
That's just the first batch. But Caitlin, what about your prom? Surely you were a nerd. Was anyone a nerd like me? Go.
I was homeschooled, so I didn't get a prom.
Wish you went with your mother.
No, I did go. I did go to the before and after parties with friends who went to public school, but I did not get to go to the actual prom, which was at the Space Needle.
Oh.
The year I would have gone, it would have been fantastic. Up top.
Wow.
But I didn't go. I sat at home.
But you got a prom 8 times a week on Broadway.
I had the best makeup prom ever. Yeah. I got to wear a fancy tux every night.
So is Chris Sieber. Okay. So
are you eating, Chris?
I had some jelly beans. And here. Yeah. Kevin loves them. Kevin loves them. I was like, oh, jelly beans. Okay, that's great. But
I have, jelly
that have every flavor under the sun.
Yeah.
I think I got earwax and boogers.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Not good.
Ooh,
it's not good.
Okay, so you know, my favorite kinds of stories about mess ups on stage. Anybody have a prom mess up I want to hear about?
We never mess up.
We're perfect.
Let's just harken back to that one night.
They were all me.
Chris?
We had done the photo shoot starting in the morning.
Right.
And it was the top of act two scene. Brooks, what happened that night?
Well, I mean, first of all, during the first act, Chris Sieber, who is a paid professional,
it started at the end of the first act when he did that riff.
Well, right? I will also the end of Acceptance.
Go ahead.
What was it? What was it? Just to be clear.
So the end of Chris's song, Acceptance, he sings, he's supposed to sing, make rainbows come true. Right, yay, bravo.
I was feeling good. I will just say that. I was feeling good.
And in it, and you all of a sudden, you just turn and you're like, Meg, Rainbow Dance. And they couldn't get to the top. And
I felt good, and I thought I could go the octave higher. It's like, Meg, Rainbow Dreams come true. Now, it came out like this. Make rainbow dreams come true.
A sensible slide down.
It was so bad.
Have it somewhere.
We have it somewhere. Yeah, it's out there.
So that started the whirlwind to us all losing our equity cards for being lack of professionals. So go ahead, Brooks and Chris, about the top two scenes.
We got through to the intermission.
First, you must say that I am always the rock.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. So with Chris, go. Absolutely. Chris is always the one that he'll come and he'll get us back together. He always does.
Not tonight.
Jeff and I are dying. Chris, first of all, the trow happened. We get to the intermission where, of course, we talk
about it. Right after, too.
This is insane. I mean, what are we doing? We get to the top of Act Two where we're all the people on the screen right now. Those five people, we are on stage together. And it's still in our heads. And things
get. You can hear everyone's voice kind of
quivering. And we hope to God we get to Chris's line. We barely get our way there. He has like an long exit line.
Just a monologue.
And he, Chris, I mean, do what you did, Chris. I mean, it was sort of,
I can't remember, but I just remember that it was so staccato.
I can't remember the words.
Word by word.
But then you also repeated it. You would like get halfway into it and then mess up a little bit and go back to the beginning and start again.
It was awful. Every time we messed up, we would fall apart. The end of that scene was, I don't know, about 25 minutes.
And it got to the point where the audience was so involved in our...
They knew what the joke was.
That they broke into applause.
Yes.
Not once, but like three times.
Right.
I have never in my entire professional, all the 80 years that I have been doing this, never experienced a moment like that. People still talk about it to this day. Yeah. I was in the audience when you added 5 minutes to the show because the olds couldn't.
But the best part is they all leave and go out the door. And all you do is hear a trickle of laughter the whole time going out the door, cracking themselves up into the wing, and I shut the door, and then I have to start the next scene, and all I get to do is listen to them laughing their asses off.
Yeah.
And I had this exit line, which made us all giggle, except the audience. And it was this stupid line where Trent would come back after he left and just go, anon, and then leave. And it was just so out of place and so stupid that we loved it. I loved it. I thought it was hilarious. The audience sometimes got it, and then most of the time they didn't. But
knowing your characters,
that was when the total breakdown happened. I came back and went,
that's right.
When it did not work, I would be behind the set, and Beth and Brooks had to come, and I would be splayed on the floor like I was shot in the back of the head.
Right.
How many times I did come off stage right, and I was pulling the fire alarm. Or I would hang myself with a scarf in the stairwell.
Right.
After just so bad.
Beth is working. He looks like a normal person.
James just changed laptops. He told me first he told me to quit the show and have Beth Level take over. That was the first pass.
Well, what's wrong with Beth Level taking over?
Sounds good to me.
That's a nice transition, I must say.
Just text us your questions.
Now we fixed it. In conclusion, Chris is unprofessional. That's what I got from the last story.
If we would like to sample some of it, Izzy has just informed me that she has the recordings ready to go if you want to bring her back in. And she can play that too for us.
You need to hear Chris's. You need to hear
it. I'm going to leave.
Well, there's the Lin-Lan-Lin-Lan-Lin-Lan-Lin-Lan-Manuel. That's a good one, too, if Izzy has that, because that is...
Lin-Lan, what you got?
Hey, I've got it all. Okay. Well, that was a really good one.
Well, all right, true.
Well, listen, I hope this...
We're all tired.
So tired. I hope you can hear this in my computer. Okay, wait. Let me know if you can hear this. I'm playing it from my computer. I think it'll work. Okay. Let's see.
Which one is this?
Well, we'll just see, Chris.
Yeah, just eat the jelly beans.
No?
No.
No? Okay, okay, okay. Then I will. Please hold. Wait, what? Oh.
No. That's the. Oh, that's the trumpet.
So sorry. They're not. Nope. Nope.
Nope.
These are all.
There's Beth.
That in means no. Sense,
communication. Oh, here. This is one of them.
You understand it and understand.
Yeah, that was.
Well, oh.
You
understanding may lead to, dare I say it, love.
Pick up Minan.
Wow. And you.
All right, that's.
But if you have Rainbow Dreams, because that one.
I do. It's not labeled. I have the zip file with all of them, but on my computer it's labeled. I will get it. I will get to it. You can leave me if you need me to.
And then there's the Lin-Manuel one.
Oh, careful with mine. They get dirty.
Oh, here's Lin-Man. Got okay. Lin-Man.
Pretty great, huh? Take that, Miranda.
Yeah, terrible. You're a terrible actor.
No.
Oh, anyway,
I know.
What is
this? How did your show run past one performance?
It's the worst.
That was my favorite.
We had no fun.
So I'm working, Izzy. If you find it again, just wave or just text Kaylin. I'll bring you back.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm ready. Text me.
Can you guys tell me any fast ones that Brooks pulled during the show? Because he's notorious for remaining blank face himself, but forcing everyone else to laugh.
I'm not hearing from.
My favorite.
Look at
Seth. My favorite thing that he did was whenever he would mess up, he would really double down and say what he said wrong again.
Yeah. He couldn't let it go, so he would make the mistake and fuck up. And it wasn't a major thing, too. It was like a little trip of the tongue. But he would go back and do it again. And then if he tripped that up, he'd do it a third time. I gotta get the line out.
I was trying to tell that story.
Do the one about, Brooks, do the one about the gym.
Oh.
It's a simple line. Most actors have no problem with it.
It was, the line is supposed to be. I'm talking about Caitlin's character, and I'm talking to all the old people, and I'm saying, she's going to get this. We're going to give her this prom, damn it, kind of thing. And I was supposed to say, I don't care if we have to decorate that gym with our own blood and hair. Emma's getting the prom she deserves. That was the line. And I went to the wrong word first or something, and I just grabbed onto Beth, and I said, I don't care if we have to bloody, dirty gym. That bloody, dirty gym with blood.
And it was blood and hair and meat, and he was also doing this. You're also doing this.
And then Beth had to do the next line, and all she did, I finally finished. I was like, she's gonna get the prop she deserves. And Beth did this. And just said the line. Perfect.
I think Izzy has another one. Another
Izzy
one.
Is ready with Rainbow Dreams.
Okay. Yes. Enjoy.
All right, Rainbow Dreams come true.
Have you heard this?
Rainbow Dreams come true!
So good. Also, if we want a doubling down of Brooks, I've got lots of wigs.
Let's. I am as gay as a box of wigs.
Thank you. I can bow out again.
Wait, see, there's one that Brooks did that was.
She's like the historian of the ball.
Yes.
This Smithsonian with the Dewey Decimal System.
Brooks had one too that it was like, we're gonna, for deliveries, whatever that was. That was so out of just, you know, our brains were, we were tired. We were working so hard to make the show run and did every event, and our brains were full. And so
what was that? What were you supposed to say?
Well, I was supposed to like right after that, Rainbow Dreams Come True, and we're in the hotel and I'm meeting her basically saying, hey, let's get you, I'll help you dress for the prom. Kind of
got some dresses at home or something.
What am I supposed to say?
It was something about,
Well, but I have a lot of dresses in my own closet for emergencies. Kind of a silly little thing. And I said, for whatever reason, being elderly and tired, I said, I happen to have a few party dresses in my closet for delivery. And then I turned around and I said,
and then there's a like, what?
You said the deliveries. What? On stage.
Just wanting
I don't know how we got through 8 shows a week. I really don't.
We'll love Brooke's wanting. Your dance is in your lesbian shirt.
Well, you know, you guys did get through, and I wanted to, there's two letters. I'm going to just read one of these. Maybe we'll have time for the other one, but you're going to love this. And I know.
By the way, don't forget to donate.
That's right.
StarsInTheHouse.com. Then when you book your seats, email it, StarsInTheHouse2020@gmail.com. And then someone will read it and make the same mistake they did 8 times a week. Go.
So this is from Margaret. She said, there's so much loss in our area. I live in Bergen County, a coronavirus hotspot, but watching your show gives me hope. My daughter's musical, Mamma Mia, was postponed, and yet all the seamstresses known as the drama mamas took all the leftover fabric and sewed masks for our local hospitals. That's theater people, even at the high school level. The next loss coming our way is prom, which brings me to why I'm writing to you. Our favorite show last year was The Prom. My daughter and I laughed, cried, and fell in love with everything about this show. We went for the closing show and cried from the opening number to the final bows. April 24th would have been my daughter's prom, her first prom. I was going to make me cry with her first girlfriend. Her dress is hanging in her closet. So here's my ask. Would you please do a prom reunion show?
That's why we did it when I got that letter.
We did it. And to top that all off, she can still wear her beautiful prom dress. We're holding a virtual prom for kids who have gotten their proms canceled because of COVID. You can take a video of yourself partying it out in your best suit, dress, whatever you wanted to feel fabulous in, and send it to broadwaypodcastnetwork.com/prom2020. Send it, because we're trying to build like an epic prom for those kids who can't go this year.
Yes.
Is that correct?
There it is.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay. Oh, now listen to this. This is another one from Singapore. As a theater fan, Stars in the House is truly a light in the dark, getting to hang out with my favorite Broadway performers online. I work for a theater company in Singapore that's using StreamYard live talkbacks, because I learned about the platform through your show. You've helped us and I'm sure many other companies stay connected with our audience and our community at this difficult time. All this, and now you're giving us a prom reunion. I couldn't be more grateful. One of my biggest regrets is that I never got to see the prom live on Broadway. He lives in Singapore. Yeah. But the show, its message, and its cast have nonetheless been enormously important to me over the past year. Discovering the show restored some of my own passion for the theater and for what I do. And he made a donation to the Actors Fund on top of it.
Yay. That's amazing.
Thank you, Sean.
Thank you.
Thank you, Singapore.
You know, that's why Cast album like lives on. That's what's so great. It's like the show could be gone, but people listen to it forever. What was it like recording that Cast album?
Well, it was exhausting because we were in the middle of, it was just right after Tech, I think, or something.
Yeah.
Just opened. Really? And it was, you know, we've all of us had worked so hard on this show, just developing and everything. But also once we were in Tech and the previews and everything, it was one event after another. And we all said yes to basically everything. So we were doing all these things on top of the show, on top of rehearsal, on top of everything. Then we did the cast recording, and it was from like 9 a.m. till midnight sometimes.
Yeah.
Singing,
singing, you know, all of our songs are high and hard, and we got through them, but man, you're sitting around in that studio and trying to hit those notes I did one good take of Love Thy Neighbor, and thank God it was amazing because it was the only one that worked. It was the only one that worked because we were just so vocally exhausted and physically tired. But, you know, it's so great just to hear the orchestra in its full in your ears at once. Yeah. You know.
Brooks, that's why you look like you were marking it when I saw the show. Now I know why.
Right. It's not that I was marking. I was exhausted. Okay. No,
just, whatever.
Most of the lines I said twice.
So. Beth Level, how come, what's your name? Christine in Phantom of the Opera only has to do 6 shows a week, but you had to sing 85, 11 o'clock numbers 8 times a week. What's that about?
You're welcome. Only Mama wants to sing these songs. I'll sing it. I'll sing them. Thank you very much. No, you know what? Even when we're tired, even when our voices were like vocal fried, I'm telling you something about this show.
Right.
That energy we got back every night from the people we were changing lives and entertaining just fed our souls. And I, you know, it was really a joy belting, you know, my off.
Yeah,
8 shows a week.
Speaking of singing, Caitlin, I know you brought something, and people are champing at the bit.
They're champing.
Champing. I don't know why. All right, so Caitlin, why don't you hit it? We're gonna open up the screen by going away. Do you want your fellow clowns on screen while you sing it?
No,
they can be on screen. It doesn't matter.
No, it's all about you.
It's all about you.
Yeah, you should.
But then I'm alone.
Yeah, Caitlin.
Okay. Izzy's coming back, though.
What? Oh, damn. I wasn't.
You're up. You're up.
Bye. I'm getting it ready. Are you staying?
I don't know. Am I?
But I have a really bad echo. Now, do I have the echo? I don't. We're going to do this. It's going to be great. Okay. Here we go. Some hearts can conform, fitting the norm, flaunting their love for all to see. I tried to change, thinking how easy life could be. I just kept on failing. I guess that was a sign that there wasn't much hope for this unruly heart of mine. Then you came along, and right or wrong, feelings began to overflow. We had to hide, thinking that no one else could know. And not having you near me was where I drew the line. So I had to conceal this poor unruly heart of mine. And so I don't know how or when, but somehow I learned to see, no matter what the world might say, this heart is the best part of me. So fears all in the past, fading so fast, I won't stay hidden anymore. I'm who I am, and I think that's worth fighting for. And nobody out there ever gets to define the life I'm meant to lead with this unruly heart of mine. And so I don't know how or when, but somehow I learned to see, no matter what the world might say, this heart is the best part of me. So fears all in the past, fading so fast, I won't stay hidden anymore. I'm who I am, and I think that's worth fighting for.
And nobody out there ever gets to define the life I'm meant to lead with this unruly heart of a mind. And nobody out there ever gets to define the life I'm meant to lead with this unruly heart of mine.
Ridiculous.
Beauty girl.
I'm crying.
Yay!
No.
And look at this, Sean from Singapore.
Isn't
that great?
Caitlin, do you practice that every day, or it's just there for the moment?
I don't practice it every day, and it is not there.
I don't believe it.
Like a dream boat, as always.
I remember Brooks and I would sit in the stage left wing when she was doing the end of a song, and she's got this just clarion, beautiful, clear thing, and we're next. It's like, you ready to do your next one, stage? How about
you? Look at this. I'm so beyond happy that the prom can live on forever in the cast albums.
Yay.
Hey, Beth Level, I just sent you a list of donations. So shut down emotionally and read them, please.
Where are they? On my phone?
Yeah, I texted.
Oh, my God. Okay, ready?
Yes.
Ben from Virginia, $51. Thank you.
Yes.
Mom saw it twice, and we saw Beth Level in P-Town last summer. Love her and all of them. Thank you. Michaela M. and Snamfam from Florida. I'm sorry if I mispronounced that. $8. First and last time
Florida
was closing and was such an unforgettable moment. Never cried in the sacred walls of a Broadway theater till that day. Thank you. Karen from Maryland. $25 donated in honor of Caitlin and Izzy. They brought me so much joy as I could see them portraying my high school self, and much love to Brooks for adult me. Lori from Arizona, $103. I wanted to see Chris Sieber in something and was in New York City right after the prom opened. I had no idea what the prom was, but loved it so much. I went back 6 months later, and I live in Arizona. We'll be singing up to be signing up.
I haven't been out in 7 years.
Yeah, right.
Signing up. Sustaining, this is important. We'll be signing up a sustaining member of the Actors Fund.
Oh. Wow.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Chrissy from New York, $51. I donate because I miss Brooks and his gin.
Oh, thank you. You do.
Carrie, $51. Greetings. I want to send a message to the prom cast. Thank you for the prom. I followed this show from Atlanta to New York City. I am so proud and happy for what the creative team and the cast achieved. P.S. To whoever to read this, good luck pronouncing my name. Carrie, is that not right? C-A-R-E-Y. Carrie. Yay. See? Carrie. Robert from New York, $20. I'm going to sound great. Robert from New York, $20.
That was the voice.
This donation is from my 10-year-old son, Kyle. He is a huge fan of the prom. Thank you. Brooks, I swear to God. Sandy from North Carolina, woohoo! $36 in honor of Beth, Seth, and James and our wonderful cruise. Thank you.
That was fun.
Buddy, that's amazing. I wish we were on a cruise right now.
Oh, I'm going on a cruise so bad.
All right, I have three things to say.
Okay.
We have one more. Diane, $20. I love the prom. Thank you for this important show. That's number one. Then I want to say that Wizzer is watching from Falsettos.
Hello, Bogart. Artists. Hey.
Oh, we love Steven.
And my thing I want to say is, I didn't tell James, but this just came to me. We do this thing called Plays in the House twice a week, where we do plays. And this cast is so amazing. We got to find a play just for this cast.
Oh,
yes.
A murder mystery.
Mornings at 7.
Let's do it.
Anyone get that?
Let's do Long Days in the Trinity at night.
We need something with old people. The gin game. Julie's here, Beth.
Hi.
Hi, Joy.
We gotta have you guys back.
Yeah, she's on the phone with unemployment, by the way.
We've been on the phone for 4 hours.
It's actually 4 hours and 45 minutes.
There you go.
Oh my God.
On a Sunday.
God bless
America. Yeah, so you guys, your chemistry is so good. So try to think of a play that requires people in your age range, as we say. And finally,
Brooks, you'll just tell Peter. Peter Flynn. So there you go.
He's doing it for my apartment.
I know.
Thank God. Thank God the apartment's okay. I haven't been there in over 2 months. Like,
I love that you let him use it. And Chris, you're already in costume. All right, so before we go, this has gone on forever, but Beth, you promised to sort of basically break the internet with your belt.
Yes.
Come on, girl.
She's okay. Go ahead.
Wish me luck.
You're gonna be great.
I'm gonna be great.
Oh, the lady's improving, so don't give up.
Thank you.
Is she perfect? My answer is no. Her range needs expanding, her edges need sanding, but she can become a sure bet. So I'm begging you, son, don't give up on her. Yeah, key change. The lady's improving so much that she gloats. I know you've got standards. Feel free to give notes. There isn't an issue, and that's why I wish you could see. There's no reason to fret. So I'm begging you, sir, don't give up on her. Everybody thinks that I've got some kinks that I'll never work out. Even you're inclined to think I'm unrefined. But I promise with some time that my aptitude will climb and you'll leave your doubts and disbeliefs behind. The lady's improving, removing all doubt. Cash, you have hidden charms that are sure to come out. You're bound to discover that this book's not her cover. So don't make a move you'll regret. So I'm begging you, sir, no reneging on her. Don't give up on her.
Bravo!
Yes!
It's coming!
Good night.
Tell Steph to love that note.
I had to follow that, just so you know.
Yes. That was the longest. She held it for 36 seconds one night.
Yeah.
36?
Like it was nothing.
Of course. Oh no, I left body parts on there.
I had to follow that. So every now and then Beth would come off after she basically stopped the show and I'd go, thanks, level.
Beth, we have a season.
Wait. I just want to thank my technical director, my fiance, Adam Heller.
Adam!
Yay!
Hi, Adam!
Mwah, mwah, mwah.
You got a cease and desist from Manhattan Plaza.
From Manhattan Plaza.
Thankfully, my neighbors are sheltering elsewhere, or it would be like.
Thank God you were wearing pants. When you got up, I was like, oh, I hope she has pants on.
I have
to. No, the tuxedo ends.
I thought you were going to take more things off.
The tuxedo ends.
Pants.
Look at those gams.
I know.
In conclusion, you guys, so Brooks, it's up to you and Peter and whoever. Think of a play for you guys. I'm telling you, it would be, we get so many donations. So think of something great.
Yeah, Drama Does Play Services and service and Concord / Samuel French have been wonderful about getting right back to us about.
That's amazing. You know,
so,
got anything off the top of your head?
I was thinking
of misbehaving.
Maybe the mousetrap. The mousetrap.
The mousetrap.
In misbehaving.
Seth, we love you so much. Thank you for always doing these, Seth and James.
Thank you.
Oh, we love it.
You're amazing.
I guess before we go, I'll tell one of my favorite Brooks stories. Just one of my signatures that I always tell. Oh. We're doing the Ritz on Broadway. And there was this giant chase scene. It was a three-level set. And Rosie Perez in 85-inch heels just run around. Now, by the way, there was no payoff. The audience was never laughing. But they all had to do this exhausting chase. And Brooks and I, for some reason, weren't part of it. So we'd just be sitting in back of the set. And at one point, Rosie runs by in the heels, panting. And Brooks just goes, I don't believe you.
That sounds like typical Brooks.
Yeah. I didn't believe her.
Every now and then, Brooks would lean over to me and other people and say, you're ruining it.
You're ruining it.
You're ruining it. They don't believe you.
You guys, bye. We're going to run the ending credits. So everyone, thank you for donating.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone.
Nice to see you guys.
I love you all.
I love you, my family.
I'm going to play some prom music.
Yeah, and we'll see everyone tonight at 8 o'clock, the full monitor. Yes, hold on. Let me get this together.
This is from my prom.
Singing, Angie.
Good time, lady.
Yes. Beth, you're once, twice, three times, and I love you.
I think a buckwheat.